JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 8th. I am Haralambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, as always, let's start with the performance of the dollar. The dollar traded lower against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian morning Wednesday. It lost the most ground against NOK, CHF and Euro in that order, while it eked out some gains only against the Japanese yen. Now, the weakening of both the dollar and the yen suggests another day of risk on trading, but the strengthening of the franc points otherwise. Thus, bearing in mind that the FX performance paints a blurry picture with regards to the broader investor morale, we will turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, EU shares continued rallying for a second straight day, perhaps as investors continued cheering early signs that the coronavirus spreading is leveling off. Wall Street indices also opened higher, but eventually slid to close slightly in negative waters. The subdued appetite rolled over into the Asian session today as well. Although Japan's Nikkei gained 2.3%, China's Shanghai Composite and Hong Kong's Hang Seng are down 0.13% and 1.22% respectively. What may have put the brakes on market participants' enthusiasm may have been the acceleration in new infected cases and deaths due to the coronavirus spreading, with deaths reaching a new daily record. Although New York Governor Andrew Cuomo said that the state is nearing a plateau in the numbers of hospitalized patients, new deaths in the state were 731, the highest within a day since the pandemic's outbreak. In Spain, deaths accelerated as well for the first time in 5 days. The slide in oil prices may have also contributed in easing investors' risk appetite. Both Brent and WTI slid 3.57% and 9.39% yesterday, as the American Petroleum Institute reported the largest weekly gain in crude oil inventories since January 2017. Anxiety over whether major oil producers will reach an output cut deal tomorrow may have also been a reason. Now, focus for oil traders shifts to the Energy Information Administration weekly report due out today, where a confirmation of a spike in output may keep oil prices under pressure. However, the big determinant with regards to the black gold's upcoming direction may be the outcome of the OPEC Plus meeting that ends tomorrow. It would be very important to see whether producers will eventually find common ground, and if so, whether the new cuts will be enough to offset the tumble in global demand due to the pandemic outbreak. Now back to the virus saga. Even if we get another rebound in equities, we will stay reluctant to trust long-lasting recovery. Remember yesterday morning we noted that it was too early to call for a peak in the spreading of the coronavirus, and the latest acceleration makes us even more cautious. What's more, with officials across the EU pushing forward with plans to start lifting restrictive measures, we see the risk for the virus to start spreading at an even faster pace. In our view, it is too early to call off the lockdowns. We believe that they should be extended for a while more in order to ensure that the virus has indeed been contained. In any case, we stick to our guns that the global economy may start recovering well after the peak of the pandemic, as people may be hesitant getting out of their homes even after we get free movement permissions. Now, as for the rest of today's events, although the Norwegian stock market is closed, during the early European morning, we already got the nation's CPIs for March. The headline rate declined to 0.7% year over year from 0.9%, while the core rate remained unchanged at 2.1%. The Norwegian krone, which was yesterday's main gainer, barely reacted to the data, as it appears that they are unlikely to alter Norwegian policymakers' view around monetary policy. On March 19th, at an extraordinary meeting, the Norges Bank decided to reduce its policy rate to 0.25% and noted that the committee does not rule out further reductions. Norway's economy depends largely on oil exports, and if the lockdowns and restrictive measures around the globe continue to hurt demand for the black gold, officials may not hesitate to bring interest rates down to zero at their next ordinary meeting, scheduled for May 6th and 7th. After all, the effects of low oil prices are clearly visible on consumer prices. Although the core rate stands a tick above the Norges Bank inflation target, the headline one, which includes prices of energy items, is much lower. Now, later in the day, the FOMC releases the minutes of their second extraordinary meeting held on March 15th, when officials decided to reduce the federal funds target range by 100 basis points to the 0 to 0.25% range. Having said that, we expect the minutes to pass unnoticed, as investors may treat them as outdated. Since that meeting, the Fed already proceeded with additional measures in order to ease the economic damages from the fast spreading of the coronavirus, while on March 26th, Fed Chair Jerome Powell said that the Fed still has room for more policy action and that they are not going to run out of ammunition. We believe that market participants may stay on guard for tomorrow's initial jobless claims for the week ended on April 3rd. As for other data released today, Canada releases its housing starts and building permits for March and February, respectively. Housing starts are expected to have declined to 180,000 in March from 210.1K in February, while building permits are anticipated to have fallen 4.5% after rising 4% in January. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning more about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I am holding every Monday at 7 o'clock a.m. GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.